Now I'm going to give you the really good news.
Put half of it in there, though, if you want to try to win.
You know, some of the advice that you're getting tonight.
If you want a chance, you don't need it.
Just to kind of give you guys a refresher, but in July of 2014, we announced, we put out a special article on Agenda 21 Radio, and the article was basically an intelligence report that I received from my intelligence people that I get a briefing on once every couple of months. To give you kind of a feel for this, I get a group of people that I've been working with for about 5 years. Some of these are CIA, former CIA high security level people, people that have worked with presidents, people that are currently in the military, and they talk to me on a strict confidential basis. And so, proud to say that they've never been wrong about anything they've told me. So it was July of last year, they came out with an intelligence report, and they said, you got to tell the American people to get it out. And basically, it was about the suicide bombers that they were sending in across the border, Al-Qaeda folks, and so on. We're seeing this wave of immigration coming across from refugees, we're talking about. And they said that they're going to come in teams of eight, and they're going to strike 100 malls or population centers, especially gun-free zones throughout the United States of America, all in one fell swoop. And then they're going to come in with killing squads and kill as many Americans as possible, all to take place on one day. So we immediately put out a report about that going to happen. A week later, they upped it to 103 malls. And, of course, then they started adding on other targets that were going to be targeted, including high schools in particular. High school, which is, of course, to my heart, because I spent 41 years in high schools. High schools at lunchtime, in which you'd see teams of eight come in with suicide satchels and so on, blow themselves up at lunchtime, kill as many kids as possible, and come in and gun down people. My recommendation to everybody at the time, and actually the recommendation of my people, was make sure that every American gets the word to have one sidearm and one long gun. And so that's why when you hear me talk about this on the radio, about one sidearm and one long gun, we mean that, because this is the way they play. Now, since that event, and that was in, since that information came to us, there were a series of events in which six individuals died, and the attacks did not happen, just to let you know. You see, there's people on our side that know how to play the game, too, that are not affiliated with the government, just to let you know. Part of the reason is that the government is so compromised at this point, and you're probably even seeing this play out so well today. It's pretty incredible what's happening. A lot of people aren't awakened to what's happening yet. But by you guys being here right now, it's a really good sign that you're becoming more aware. And the pieces of the puzzle are starting to fit together about what this big grand plan is for the United States and the rest of the world. Am I picking? Bag of avocados. The ticket says, bag of avocados goes to Paul Preston. Okay, it's 368785. You want me to repeat that? 368785. Do we have a winner? Yes, we do. Get yourself a bag of avocados. Can you put that back in? No. Here we go. 368789. The wife got this one. Yeah. All right, I promise I won't look now. This is for the ammo. 3687 Paul Preston. No, I'm sorry. Who's this guy? 368761. Is that you? That's Larry, but he can't win.
I'll tell you what. Whoever won a bag of avocados, I'll trade him for the gum. All right?
All right, Larry. Here you go. All right. Anyway, so the situation is starting to, I think, you got, let's see, we got about 400 plus days of President Barack Hussein Obama. And if you watch, I really highly recommend you go to either agenda21radio.com, which is my website, or you go to Drudge, which is the Drudge Report out there, and check it every day. Please do. Don't depend on ABC, CBS, all these others, or even Fox News. Fox is down the chain for me, about five or six news sources down when I go and want to find out some other information, get a video clip or something like that. They are playing the game too. The game that the media is playing is all in the hands of the United Nations. Okay? It's all in the chain. It's all in the hands of all the people that want to put the agenda forward for Sharia law, Islam, China, and all this stuff. The one world order people. Okay. Now, a report that just appeared on Drudge tonight, and this is something that I've been saying for a long time. Hillary Clinton is being paid and has been paid by the Saudi government since the mid '80s. Okay? Uma Abedin, you guys have heard me talk about this ad nauseum. All right, now, this is an actual report that came out on Drudge today. So I want you to, it's not that I'm a fool, a stupid guy, or anything like that. And for the last 5 or 6 years, I've been, well, ever since Hillary's been around and I've been on the radio, I've been talking about it. So that's 14 years. There's my tinfoil hat back there, by the way. It's come true. I wear that every once in a while, and I get these facts. Anyway, story out now. Hillary supporters support Sharia law. That means no constitution. Hillary supporters support Sharia law. You get Hillary in, we get Sharia law. That's what will happen. Well, we hope she gets stoned. Yeah, well, then there's Carly Fiorina, who has some support in that direction, too. You might want to look at this. Here's for you. I'll be doing it next. Okay, anyway, they're moving very quickly, and you need to understand this, that there's a couple of things that have been happening, and I'm talking all the time on the radio. This Friday, we're going to have Trevor Loudon on. And Trevor Loudon has written his new book about the communists within the Congress, which is not really a big secret any longer, but he goes into complete detail about how this whole cabal of communists have come through. There's a real good book by Aaron Klein, which I've been citing since 2010. Aaron, and I can't remember her name, the researchers, they were both on my radio show several times. And the book is called Red Army. And it details, in detail, what is going on with President Barack Hussein Obama right now and the use of executive orders. Because they knew he would go totalitarian. They knew that. And, of course, they researched everybody. Like Luis Gutierrez, Mr. Communist himself. Who's good friends with Paul Ryan. And they both support amnesty, as does Rubio. Let me tell you what you get with amnesty. The president today announced he's ignoring the court. This is my list of stories in the morning, by the way. The president is going to defy the Supreme Court's order against amnesty that he put out there. He's allowing amnesty. Hello? I asked this question of Mr. Paul Ryan. Do you have the cojones to file articles of impeachment as Speaker of the House, Mr. Speaker, against the President of the United States? For violating the Constitution, tearing it up?
None of them are
and Paul Ryan will say, no, oh, can't we all just get along? That's Paul Ryan. You know, when you hand the keys of the empire over to a dictator, and he does what he wants to do, it shouldn't be any surprise that he's going to continue to do whatever he wants to do. Hello? The Republicans are allowing this to happen. I suggest you contact your Republican friends in the House or in the Senate and demand answers. This is the reality. Okay, anyway, as far as immigration, there's a story out. I heard it in the back here, but it's not a surprise. It shouldn't be a surprise to anybody who's listening to the show. We've been talking about how immigration has been coming in, and what they've been doing is they've been flooding communities. And one community right now they're talking about in Germany, the UK Mail has an article just popped up tonight, actually, as I was sitting back there. And the German population is all stunned that here you have a small town in Germany with 140 population and over 800 Middle Eastern, quote, refugees, of course, they're all men, 18 to 45, have just suddenly showed up in their little town. That's happening in this country. Meridian, Idaho, Twin Falls, Idaho, other places in Minnesota. And now over here, Leo Chesney. We don't know who they're bringing in there, but they're prepping the facility for somebody. That's just right around the corner. The last report we had of people coming in over here, we were told, I was told, they were going to be MS-13 kids. MS-13 kids are kids that are gangster kids, and in order to get into the gang, in order to qualify to be brought across the border, be paid for, in other words, by their coyote, they have to be brought into the gang by killing someone. You're talking about children from 17 to 7. They're all tattooed. I can't just wait until I open up the front door and some kid's standing there with tattoos all over his face says MS-13. Hey, you want to can I sell you some candy bars? Okay, that's the reality of the world we're living in. So it's kind of nice timing we had this little. If I'm trying to present this as sort of an emergency situation, the red flags are up. That's what this is. Events are moving quickly. The reason they're moving quickly is the Pope showed up. The Pope showed up, and what the Pope did is he was the signal that the New World Order people have decided they're going to move up Agenda 21 by 20 years. You see, their plan with Agenda 21 was one world domination, no borders. It was going to be completed by 2050. However, they decided, well, things aren't really going our way. Things aren't happening the way we think they're going to go. We're running out of time. We're running out of time because they're finding out. You are finding out. People are finding out. Americans are finding out. They're finding out that the media... listen, most media and news and information does not come by way of the mass media anymore. It comes by people researching on the internet. It's about 75% of news is being delivered now that way. So the mass media is out of it. People don't believe them because why? They're lying. So I'm giving you a little bit of a heads up. What I'm finding in my news cycle, when I give the news out, when I report, and especially from my sources, and there are many. By the way, I rely upon citizen journalists who I've now known, some of them for 7 years, who just started listening to the show, then we started emailing. And some of the stuff is absolutely spot on. So, I get good information. It's reliable information. I'm finding in my news cycle that sometimes news that I produced 3 years ago is now showing up on Fox. That's what's happening. They're just ignorant dolces as far as I'm concerned. Ignorant. And willfully ignorant. That's what they are. I don't know if any of you disagree with me, but just take a look at these guys. Charlie Rose the other day with, I think it was Marco Rubio, actually, talking about immigration.
Rubio nailed him.
I mean, I'm really, there's a lot of things, I don't like the amnesty thing, but Rubio nailed him about, you know, this whole thing about amnesty and what's going on with Hillary Clinton and all that stuff about, you know, her lying and so on. Charlie, was you calling the former Secretary of State a liar? Yeah. Charlie Rose is, you know, so that's the kind of meeting that we have. National borders, story that I'm going to talk about tomorrow. George Soros. National borders are the obstacle. National borders are the obstacle. See how the one world order people think? Do away with the border for California, for Nevada. And what about these crazy people with Jefferson who want to establish a more perfect union by having more borders and autonomy? Isn't that kind of interesting that all of a sudden now this is coming out? The reason it's coming out is because they came up with another plan. And you heard me talk about this the other day, and now you'll hear me, you've been hearing me talk about it on the radio a lot, and that's the brand new plan called Agenda 2030. And with the plan Agenda 2030, they've upped it to 15 years from now. They said, we're not gonna go to the one world order business by 2050, we're moving it up to 2030. Does that make sense? And they're being pressed by us. So you're going to see, that's why you're starting to see Gavin Newsom, other people who want to throw in things about the Second Amendment. They want to get that on the next ballot. They're trying to push all this stuff quicker and faster. They're doing exactly what totalitarians do in the end. They overplay their hand. And there's one thing they have not counted on. That's the American. They do not understand we Americans. And they're in for some bad times. Now, the word that we've been hearing is a lot of immigrants come to this area. Sacramento is a designated welcoming communities area by the president. We reported this months ago. 10,000 to be here soon. All from the Middle East. One in three immigrants, by the way, reported on Drudge today, tonight. One in three immigrants, or refugees, into America right now are from Africa. No one from Europe, no Christians. Very telling, isn't it? Tom.
A while back, you mentioned the 17 airliners that came into, I don't remember the state, Somalis.
Okay, I reported, how many of you ever heard of John Murtha before? Was in the House of Representatives, former Marine, Mr. Major Bozo, a monster in my opinion. He was really big into the earmarks, remember? And one of the things that he was into was building this big, huge airport in western Pennsylvania for international aircraft and all that stuff. You know, you got Pittsburgh International and other international. Why would you do that, John? So I was talking to the guy who owns Constitutional Patriot Radio, who lives in Johnstown, Pennsylvania. And I was talking to him, and I was talking to Ruthie Hendrick, who, by the way, will be at the Liberty Tour. She's a specialist on immigration. She's been doing the Ruthie Report since 2006 on illegal immigration. She has a lot to say about what's going on. And so we're on this conference call, and I'm talking to Ruthie a little bit, and all of a sudden, Mike Collins, who owns the station, he speaks up and says, oh yeah, he said, we've got Somalis all over the place here in Johnstown. Oh really? So then he goes on and talks about these 17 large airliners, 747s, 757s and the like, that were all allowed to land. In fact, they closed down the Murtha Airport and allowed all these large airliners to land, 17 of them. And anywhere from 250 to 300 Somalis disembarked off each plane. I don't care that many batteries, but I have thousands of them. And just settled in that area, western Pennsylvania. Right, if you, the government's paying for their housing, this is a huge money grab. I call it trafficking in human flesh and slavery. And the churches, the Catholic Church in particular, is really big on it. They're making billions of dollars on this for housing these refugees. There's more refugees being moved around the planet right now by the powers that be, states, government, and so on, than ever in human history. So I'm trying to tell you, you got to get the gravity of this right now and see the magnitude of this. Tom? Right. Well, okay, good question, because a lot of the Muslims have been kept over, a lot of the Islamists, if you will, because what a lot of them, they said, they estimated to be between 10 and 30 million destined for Europe, 10 million to go right into Germany. They have been funneling through into Germany, and the reason for the disappearance in a lot of cases is they have been boarding airliners from Berlin or from Germany and flying into Mexico, and they come here. That's the route. That's the route. Yeah. That's what we just talked about. Yeah, that's in part the answer for that. So these are all men, fighting age, and so on. There are ammunition and weapons stores already here currently in the country. And they've been here since the 80s. So this shows you how long this has been planned. They're doomed to fail, and that's just the end of that. I can tell you that. Well, as far as I know, they're just being rented as empty. Well, they're not empty, but they're just being rented as commercial properties in various parts of the country. I know specifically about stores outside of Ontario, California, and in the Van Nuys area, specifically. Oh, climate justice. That's the other thing. Something cheery. The 2030 conference on climate is going to be happening at the end of this month. This is what the Pope kicked off. That's why the Pope was here. Now, the Pope and the President see eye to eye on everything. Did you know that? Everything. Now, if that doesn't frighten you, I don't know what does. So at the end of this month, climate justice is going to happen in the United States. And what's going to happen is the United Nations is going to meet in Paris, and the President's going to be there, and he is going to foist climate policies upon the American government without congressional approval. Remember, he pulled the same stunt with Iran. Remember that? That was just kind of warming us up for the next stunt, which is climate. And it's called, one of the big things that they're pushing is climate justice. I talked about this on today's show. Climate justice is where they're going to come up with laws and restrictions on countries throughout the world, and they're going to impose fines and punishment and things like that on various countries. So we're going to be under the wick, if you will, environmentally speaking, and for just about everything else, by the United Nations. That's one of the reasons why they want to take our weapons away from us, so we don't, you know, resist them. All I can say is good luck on that one when that comes up. Yes, ma'am? What's that? At the end of this month, I think it's the 25th through the 11th of December. The 25th of maybe the 27th of November and the 11th of December is that time frame. So look for it. Watch us on Agenda 21 Radio. Debbie Bacigalupi will be here at the Liberty Tour to talk specifically about that. And man, she got tons of stuff that's happened. And of course, we've got other people that are going to be there talking about it specifically too. The other one who's going to be here is Patrick Wood. And he's just got more information than ever about what's happening and what we can do to stop it. Yes, ma'am.
When is your Liberty Tour? And where is it?
The Liberty Tour is a week from this coming Saturday here. And the doors open at 7:30. Preppers, we have 20 preppers. Some of the people are here tonight, plus others will be in the big church over there. It's a big, big day for the Jefferson people, because if you have not heard, Jefferson now has 11 counties that are on board. They also have three more that are going to follow suit here shortly. They got the signatures, so that's three more, that's 14. We also have three more that came on that have organizing committees that look like they're gonna go. And one of them, they're Tuolumne, Almendore, and Calaveras counties. So that's, what, 17. And then we have two more that are going, and also want to announce tonight, if we have not heard the news, is that Josephine County in Oregon has started their process officially. And so we've got Josephine County, it looks like Douglas Jackson, I think it is, and a couple of other counties up there that are kind of stirring. I probably let that out of the bag. Yes, ma'am, got one more.
And then I carry one of my constitutions.
What's that?
I carry one of my constitutions.
What?
Yeah.
Butte, I haven't heard anything about Butte County. I haven't heard a word. All I know is that we're in this. I talked to Mark Ward just about, or to Mark Baird just about every other day, and talked to him today. We talked about process. What's it look like when we get to the state level? And it's going to be really exciting. Because I don't think they're going to stop us, quite frankly. I think they're going to, the cards come out. It's going to be, they're going to sit around, and they're going to end up looking like all of us look at when we hear about the president's decisions, like, what just happened? And somebody was here that was at Calusa? Who was that? We had somebody here, and can you tell us what happened? This is the greatest story of American democracy, I think. I'm going to put you on the spot. But in Calusa County, Mark Beard went and told the supervisors that the sovereign people spoke, and you county supervisors, you don't mean anything.
So tell us about this.
Uh-huh. Well, the Board of Supervisors, this county, the Sovereign Council, has said Jefferson Declaration, went to the first retelling, talked to them individually, and so forth. So they finally decided to go ahead and get signatures from the people, see how that went. Actually, we did talk to a couple of supervisors individually, and they, as individuals, are for it, but they're scared that California is going to withhold Sites Reservoir and so forth, so they're all upset about that. But we went ahead and went to Calusa City, and they unanimously declared the state of Jefferson for the city of Calusa. Went to Williams, they turned us down. I went back one night and told them, I said, hey, we're going to dance for the ones that brung us, so if you guys want to get on board, you better do it quick. And so they went ahead and passed the declaration. So with those two cities and the hundreds of signatures, we went ahead and declared the county seat of Jefferson. Mark came down, and we told the Board of Supervisors, as they all stood there with their mouths wide open, wondering what to do from here. So anyway, it's kind of exciting news for all of us.
There's a... There's a great video you can see of this happening. Now that you know the inside story, if you get to that video, go to the Jefferson website. It's timeforfifty1.org. SOJ51.org. And go there and you can see it. And you have to look at the supervisors' faces. And three of the supervisors said afterwards, well, I guess that when the election comes, I'm going to be gone. I'll be voted out. And Mark said, that's true. Hello? So the politicians just lost their credibility there. So that's some just fantastic news. You just have to carry that forward. But the bigger stuff is that the federal government is really putting on a lot of pressure on us right now. And I don't know, I got the crystal ball, I have some thoughts on the whole thing. The best thing you can do, and this is my best advice to all of you, be lawful. Be lawful. Do not be unlawful. Do not run around, steal things, just do stuff that would add to the corruption, because what they are trying to push for is unlawful behavior by everybody, because that collapses our system. And they want to come along and replace it with their laws, like Sharia. Get it? This is what dictators do. They have to collapse the legal system in any country to gain power. So I always say, do things lawfully. If you want to own a gun, be a lawful gun owner. Get your CCWs. Do the things you need to do for self-protection. That's legal. and do whatever you can do to derail any of this stuff that we're hearing about in the legislature and so on by coming here and being involved as Tea Party people. I got to tell you, look around. I want you guys to look around here and look at who you're sitting with. These people fear us. They truly do. You're sitting there thinking, we're all ages in here. The fear comes from the fact that we know what freedom and liberty in the American way of life is. And they fear that. Because that's going to be their undoing. And they know it. And that's why they're rushing right now. They're making mistakes. You know, I used to coach football. I used to coach basketball as a head basketball coach. And I always knew when I was ahead in the game, and I was watching the other team play, and they start to force things. You know, they do a quicker snap count, or they would pass the ball a little bit quicker and be a little bit more aggressive on defense and stuff like that. And I always end up winning the game because I just let them go to their own demise. And that's what totalitarians do. They force things because they're anxious. They have age working against them. George Soros, I think it's his late 80s, early 90s. If you don't know the history of George Soros, he's Hungarian. He's Jew. He's a Jewish. He's born Jew. And when his parents, when it came time for them to be taken up by the Nazis in World War II, he said, great, I'm going to go with the Nazis. And so as a young kid, he was an informer for the Gestapo. And when Jews were picked up, what he did was he took all their plunder from their homes. That's how George Soros got his wealth during World War II. Isn't he a nice guy? And he hates America. You talk about the marijuana initiatives, he's funding all that. You talk about Jefferson, Black Lives Matter, he's funding all of that. He's funding everything that opens borders, destroys borders, or does anything to destroy the American way of life. He's not in play 100% with Jefferson yet. But we know they're feeling around. Yeah, Tom. He's done all that stuff. I mean, he's just got a whole history of trying to bring down Western civilization. And so he's all in on the Nazi behavior. Okay, I think I've covered all. By the way, kids 12 and under are free at the Liberty Tour. Kids 12 and under, we have Jake McCauley coming. You saw him before, but he's going to really give a fantastic presentation. We're trying to bring the youth in. So buy your tickets. We've got all kinds of stuff going on. From the last Liberty Tour, we've got CDs and so on, and Chris Ann Hall, and Clive and Bundy's presentation at the first Liberty Tour. Yes, ma'am. There's tickets available at the door. You can go to come here and get tickets. They have tickets here available also. You can also go on the internet and buy them on the internet. Go to agenda21radio.com and click on the icon. It says right across the board and the right-hand side. It's got one of those icons in the back door back there on the right, red, white, and blue. Click on that, and it comes up with the tickets available. And click on My Cart, add to cart, or whatever it says. Okay, any other questions? Tom? All right.
Tom has a comment.
Yeah, that's what I was going to comment on. I just wanted to say that when it comes to freedom of speech, I've been practicing it everywhere I go and having the greatest time. So do it.
Yeah, I'll end it on this. Carla has a question.
I want to know if there are any tickets left for the Liberty Tour.
Yes, there are tickets left for the Liberty Tour in the back there.
And that's where we get them is back here?
Yep, and we can get somebody to open it up and sell tickets. Somebody over there. Becky. I think my grandma had a ticket thing.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so here's the ticket thing. But I want to leave you because I'm being told to be quiet because we're late for the happy hour. I want to leave you with this, is that, you know, I say one thing at the end of each hour on my radio show. I say, stay strong, America. Stay strong, America. We are exceptional Americans. And remember, the people that are trying to destroy us are not exceptional human beings at all. And they don't know and understand we Americans. So I want to emphasize that with you. And also, you're going to start getting questions now. Now, I think this is probably what Thomas is talking about. You are the tinfoil hat folks. And almost all of you have, with your family members or people that you have known, have always been right, and they're kind of looking at you like, how do you know so much? And now when we've gotten getting closer to these times, there's more information coming to more people. I'm getting more questions by internet, by text, by family members, by liberal family members. They're going, how come you were right about this 3 years ago? Well, you know, now they can see. So my words to you is, help them along. Don't get argumentative, just help them along, and get the hook, but help them along, and remember, you are exceptional Americans.